one place, in one tabernacle with Jesus. In one place, in one tabernacle with Jesus. There is no other place where I'd rather be than in one place, in one tabernacle with Him.
Ready? Welcome to In His Presence. I'm your host, Johnnie Jackson. Want to say happy holidays to everyone, and I hope you are enjoying this beautiful season that God has blessed us with. I am thrilled to have as my guest today phenomenal members of the body of Christ. We have Sister Carla Clay Alexander, and also a motivational moment we're including in the show featuring Miss Cornita Castle. And to top it all off, we're going to have music and a word by Pastor Kendall Washington. So sit back and enjoy what God has for you on this day. I'd like to welcome to the set at this time Miss Carla Clay Alexander. We've been trying to make this happen for quite some time
yes,
now.
Yes, ma'am.
And I am thrilled to have you with us today.
I'm honored to be here.
Well, tell us what's going on in the life of Carla Clay Alexander.
Well, currently, I just released a new song. It's called Use Me, and it was featured on Dayton United Volume 1 through the efforts of Tommy McGuffey.
Oh,
so,
wonderful.
Yeah, so it was about 10 of us who from Dayton area, local area, and we all submitted songs so that we could have a local artist, Dayton artist, so just to showcase some of the Dayton talent here. So that was really fun. It was nice to be a part of that project. So I'm just out in the community trying to push that song so that everyone could hear it and hopefully support it. So,
that's awesome.
Yeah.
Now, I was reading, you started your music at the age of 9. I think that is wonderful. You came from your mom's womb knowing what your calling was. Tell us a little bit about that. What you said you got started in your mom's basement.
Yes, that was funny. Yeah, at 9, yeah, I had a red tape recorder. That's when tape recorders were coming out, and it was a red one that I had to have, so my mom made sure I had that. So a couple of friends in the neighborhood across the street, just a group of us, about like four of us, we would take turns performing for our parents in one another's basement. Okay. So we did some songs. Now our songs wasn't gospel back okay. then. You know, we had some Earth, Wind, and Fire.
Okay.
We were doing some Whispers. You know, just what was out at that time. So we would. I remember one of the songs was Shining Star, for Earth, Wind, and Fire, and our parents would go to one another's home and. We would wear red and blue was our color. We had red turtlenecks and blue pants, and we performed for them. And we just liked singing, and I guess that stayed with me to where okay. I loved it. And if I wanted to get away from it, evidently, you know, God just had his hands on me to make sure that I continued with singing. So I've always just liked to sing. So
that's wonderful. That's wonderful.
Thank you.
Now, you live here in the Dayton area.
Yes, ma'am.
And I know you're a member of Pleasant Green.
Yes, I am.
And you are the youth music minister there.
No, I served as the youth director
for
10 years. Yeah. So
okay.
now those kids are now grown. So they're
really?
Like 30. Five and things with their own kids, so you know it's just really.
Stop it! You're telling my age now. Stop it! Stop it! I can't.
And, yes,
that was wonderful.
Yeah, it was a blessing just to be able to be used, because I just get a joy out of young people singing, just
okay.
kids singing for the Lord, and it just touched my heart. So I was just led there. So that I knew God. Placed me there to do that. So
okay.
Just to, you know, encourage young people to sing when you're going through troubles and you're at school and not understanding things, or maybe having friendship troubles and test anxiety or things like that. You know, Christ is there. You can always just refer back to certain songs that we may sing on Sunday. You know, so I wanted them to know, just keep Christ with you wherever you go. You know, it's not just on
Sundays. And
that's
awesome, because you answered my next question, which was, what word is there that you could give or leave with the young people that would inspire them, especially those who are interested in music?
Mm-hmm.
And what you said is right on point. Mm-hmm. The music that we sing on Sunday morning or in our services, or we hear mm-hmm. On the radio, are words of encouragement.
Yes, most definitely.
And a lot of times it helps us
mm-hmm.
to get through a difficult time in our lives.
Yes, ma'am. Oh, yes. Even myself on the job, you
mm.
know, you just never know what you come, what you're faced with. So, especially when you're working for the Lord. So,
right.
Whenever there's a performance or an engagement, you know, the devil just seems to get busier, because he stays busy. You know, he does his job.
Right.
You know, are we doing ours? But, you know, he continues to want to throw you off track and lose your focus, so that you can't focus on the assignment that God has for you. Mm-hmm. So even before our interview today, you know, the devil, he tried it, but I recognized, you know, and that is so important, to recognize where it's coming from, and that way you can, you know, combat it and fight it and speak against it. So
right.
you know,
right?
Yeah.
Now you were saying that you recognized it.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think a lot of people have a problem recognizing what is being sent from God and what is maybe a divine intervention? Or I know I'm going through this class right
mm-hmm.
now, Detours.
Okay.
And a lot of things
detours.
Happen.
Okay.
In our lives,
mm-hmm.
we look at them as being, I don't need this or whatever.
Yeah.
But God is using that.
My goodness. Mm.
To take us
Say
where
it.
He would like for us to be.
Yes.
Talk to us a little bit about that.
Well, I will say, you asked if people have problems recognizing where it's coming from, who, if it's actually God using. And I will say yes, because I know I had a problem with that.
Mm-hmm.
So I didn't always recognize when it was God. And So, but that came with more studying and more reading his word, and it just made so much, made things more clear to the reasons why our road may be going down a certain path. And then when you recognize that and you find out, you like, you know, okay, God, that's why I had to go through this, so right. that I could get where you needed me to be. And I love him for that. At the time going through, it doesn't feel good.
No,
you know,
it doesn't
feel good. But, you know, now I look at it like, okay, God, you have a reason for this, and I'm going to come out on the winning end, and it's going to be for your glory. So I stopped complaining, although, you know, sometimes, you know, flesh creeps up a little bit, and, you know, but again, you have to realize that's the devil wanting you to complain and wanting you to be, you know, miserable and worrying all the time. That is a struggle, to worry, worry, worry. So knowing that God has his hands in it, although, you know, we may not be able to see him moving in that. I mean, that is just, God is just amazing. He's
yes,
amazing
he is.
Because he will reveal it in its time.
Right.
But the thing is, we have to keep going through it and not to quit, not to give up, not to turn our back on him, and not to stop following him. And I was not always there.
Right.
I was not always
you
there.
Know, a lot of people call them growing pains.
Mm-hmm.
You
My
know?
Goodness. Oh, yes.
Sometimes to get us where we need to be,
mm-hmm.
he has to, you know, light a little fire there.
That's so true. That's so true.
But it's all working for the good.
Mm-hmm.
It's
that's
all
it.
Working for
that's,
the good.
That's it.
Well, tell us mm-hmm. about your family. I know your wonderful husband is here with us
yes,
in the
studio. Yes, he is. Yes, he is.
Mm-hmm. So tell us about your family.
Well, I am married to Dr. Sylvester Alexander, and he is a great support for me, and he puts up with me, and I'm not always an easy little piece of work, as I may think I am, but he puts up with me, and he encourages me, and he loves the Lord as well, so he gives me those little nuggets that I need if I'm just falling short, you know, because we need that leaning post and somebody to lean on. I'm also a grandmother, so of a three-year-old, so I just love him to death. I have a grandson named Cameron and my daughter, Carmen, so they live in Chicago. So,
oh.
yeah, so I'm looking forward to seeing them for the holiday season. So,
that's wonderful.
Yeah. So,
wonderful.
Yeah, and my family's now. Here in Dayton, Ohio, so...
Mm-hmm. I am just so thrilled to have you with us here today.
Mm-hmm.
And
you.
You're going to provide us with another selection.
Yes, I am.
And tell us about this song.
This song is called Use Me. And this is a second single, because I had a first single called Surrender. And that was my first time putting out music as far as recorded music. So the song Surrender, I had to surrender some things, mm-hmm. surrender some thoughts, some behaviors, you know, so I had to go through that transition. So the follow-up to that song is Use Me. So now that I have surrendered, Lord, I need you to use me. I want you to use me. Use me for your glory. So the song, it came to me asking the Lord to just take away things that's not like him and change me so that I can be used and so I can recognize what you want me to do. Also, too, just to, as I start the song, it's I'm looking for peace because there's trouble all around, but I know there's peace in him. So as I'm speaking out and you know, I'm letting him know, like, Lord, I know there's peace in you. So provide that for me. Take away things that's not like you. Take away these heavy burdens and all the things that you don't want me to be. Take it away. And then show me and show me the plan that you have for me. Because sometimes we don't know. Sometimes we just don't know the plan that he has. So it's like, Lord, if you change me and you show me, then I can fulfill that plan that you have for me. So I just want him to use me.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome back Miss Carla Clay Alexander. Use me.
Put your hands together.
searching for an answer, seeking where to find a peace of mind. All around me there is trouble. I know that your peace is available to me. I know you know what's best for me, but Lord, I just can't see the plans that you have for me. Change me to do what I should, and I will do the good works you have begun in me.
Use me,
Lord.
Use me, Lord.
Use me, Lord. I wanna be used for your glory.
Use me, Lord.
Use me,
Lord.
And clean me,
use me, Lord.
Lord, I'm available to you. I've been searching for an answer, seeking where to find a peace of mind. All around me there is trouble. I know that your peace is available to me. I know you know what's best for me. But Jesus, I can't see,
just can't see
the plans that you have for me. Change me to do what I should, and I'll do the good. The good works you have begun in me.
Use me, Lord.
Change my mind.
Use me, Lord.
Change my heart. I want to be used by you.
Use me, Lord.
Restore me.
Use me, Lord.
Renew me.
Use me, Lord.
I want to be used for your glory. Don't want me to be. I want to be used by you.
Take from me.
Heavy burdens got me down. I need to know you're around.
Take from me.
All those things you don't want me to be. I want to be used by you.
Take from me.
I'm ready to be used,
Lord.
I'll say yes.
Use me, Lord.
Yes to your will.
Use me, Lord.
Yes to your way. Every day.
Use me, Lord.
You wanna
use me, Lord.
Wanna be renewed.
Use me, Lord.
Wanna be restored. Yeah.
Use me, Lord.
Use me,
Lord.
Use me,
Lord.
Use me, Lord. Thank you, Carla Clay Alexander, and your wonderful vocalists who were backing you up. Just wonderful. Thank you so much. I am thrilled to have back with us. This young lady was with us in October, and I met her through DATV, and she provided a very inspirational word for us on that evening. And I invited her to come back and provide a motivational moment. She is originally from Florida. She is a resident of Kettering, Ohio. She and her husband and children, and he is part of the military. But most of all, what is really important is she is a child of the Most High King, of the Living God. And I would like to invite to the set at this time, Cornita Castle, with her motivational moment.
Yes, hello, my name is Cornita Castle, and I just wanted to encourage you for a moment. So I've been through many things in my life, and I'm still standing here after many different things. And so I overcame sickness, I overcame depression, the situation going on with my son, he's getting better, even though, you know, I'm walking by faith. So you have to either walk by faith or you're going to walk by sight. If you walk by sight, that means you're just going to give up on life, because the enemy, when he comes at you, you see things. You're like, oh, Lord, I'm just going to give up because I see the situation. It does look like it's going to get better. But you just got to say, Lord, it's going to get better. I'm going to walk by faith. And when, because God said faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. So therefore, when you have faith and you trust and believe, then God will begin to show you exactly what your faith could have did. So when you have faith in God, after you have faith in God, then he shows it to you. It's very easy to have faith when you see things, but when you don't see something, you have faith and then God comes through for you, it builds your relationship strong with God. So point one, it will be, will you trust God by faith or will you give up on him when times get hard? That's a question I have to ask myself right now with my son being sick. Are you going to give up, Cornita, or are you going to keep trusting God? One minute I was doubting God. The next minute I was trusting God. I was crying. Then I was like, oh, Lord, this is one of the hardest things I've been through. But I said, you know what, Cornita? You've been riding this walk with God for 22 years, almost 23 years, and you're going to have to stand strong. Blood, sweat, tears, crying. Get up. Wipe your tears. Continue to walk by faith. Speak your son well, continue to speak yourself well, your family's blessed, you're blessed, walk by faith. So I encourage y'all today, what are you gonna do? Are you gonna walk by faith even when times get hard, or are you gonna give up? You can't be both ways because you get stressed out. It's either you're going all the way with God or you're not. You have to decide, because when you decide, that's when your faith with God becomes strong. Point two. On this faith walk, are you going to have faith? Are you going to fight the good fight of faith? Or are you going to give up? Because I love in Paul. Paul talked about, I choose to forget those things which are behind me so that I can press towards the walk to a higher calling. Now, he said press. He didn't say just walk through that. He said press. So those times when things are going on in your life, that's when you're going to have to press your way through. So I choose to press my way through and forgetting those things which are behind so that I can press towards the mark to a higher calling. That higher calling is being that motivational speaker. That higher calling is doing all that God has called me to do. And you pray too and you see what God has called you to do. In Jesus' name, walk by faith, not by sight. Press towards the mark. That's what I'm doing. Press towards the mark to a higher calling. What God got for you is for you. Point number three. Point number three is, so either you're going to go all the way with God or you're without God. Because so often as Christians, one minute say, well, when things are going good, we with God. When things aren't good, we're not with God. But you're going to have to get to a point in your relationship with God when you say, Lord, I'm all in, period. I'm all in or you're all the way out. Because God said in this word, a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. And he said, and expect nothing from God. So it's either you're going to be with him through the good and the bad, put on your armor of God, fight the good fight of faith, or either you're going to waver in your faith and you're going to give up. What's your choice? I choose to stand today and to be strong and to come back with a praise report saying God has worked it all out and I'm going to keep riding this walk with God. And I encourage you to fight the good fight of faith and never give up, because with God, all things are possible. Keep it moving forward. Pray, forgive. Thank you and God bless.
Thank you, Cornita Castle. What a inspirational moment. It was awesome. Thank you so much. Now, at this time, I am delighted to have on the set with me Pastor Kendall Washington. Pastor Washington is a native of Chicago, Illinois, who resides currently here in Dayton.
Yes, ma'am.
married to the beautiful Leslie Washington.
Yes.
And they recently celebrated 27 years of holy matrimony.
Yeah.
That is wonderful.
Thank you. Thank you.
And I know for a fact you took her away for your anniversary. So how was that trip? Was it nice?
We actually celebrated in town.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, we did.
Okay.
Yeah, we did.
All right. Yeah. All right, that's good too.
Absolutely.
That's great as well. You're the father of 6 children.
Yes.
Grandfather of 6.
Yes.
And he has ministered the gospel for 31 years.
Long time.
That's a long time.
Long time.
Yeah. And pastoring 22 of those years.
Yes.
So, 6 must be a one of your favorite numbers.
I guess. I guess.
Okay. So tell us what's happening in the life of Pastor Washington at this time.
Well, first of all, let me say I'm honored to be here.
Thank you.
You can have anybody here beside me, and I'm just honored to be here. I'm on the road full-time preaching right now, and it's a journey within itself. It's a whole nother level of faith and how God is using me to go to different places, different cities. And it's quite enjoyable. And we're just grateful for what he's doing right now. Spend a lot of time with the grandchildren.
That's awesome.
And it kind of frees up my time to do that. But just doing that and preaching by itself is my life. I love doing that. I love ministering the word. I love encouraging people. It's my calling to encourage people. I think one of my members put it so succinct some years ago when I read it to him as an ex-member of mine. He said, "Pastor, I love you, man, because no matter who we were and what we did, you never threw us away."
Mm.
And it's something that I have. Church is just so different now from when I came up and when you know, but. The message of Christ doesn't change.
Exactly.
We have a lot of people that's saying it differently. The method may change, but the message should not. So I just enjoy doing what I do.
Oh, and you do it well. So
I do my best.
Yeah, you do it well. That's awesome. one of the things I wanted you to talk to us about. Is entering the presence of the Lord, you know, seeking God at this time. I'm trying to explain this, how I'm feeling it.
Yes, ma'am.
But I know for me, I can talk from my own life experience. I am seeking more of Him. And wanting to feel and be in His presence continuously. A number of people have expressed to me that they have problems getting there. Do you have a word that you could give them that would help them get in that light, in that presence?
Well, I think the first thing we need to understand is this. It's the simplicity of the gospel that will teach us anything. I think that the world now is trying to be so deep that they're drowning people.
Mm.
John 3:16 and 3:17 puts it so direct. "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Then the 17 says, "For God sent not His Son into the world to condemn the world, but the world through Him might be saved." Now, before you can get an understanding of how to go to Him, you have to have an understanding of why He came to us.
Mm.
And people are trying to go. I remember in the Old Testament with the Tower of Babel, people said, "We're going to build a tower that's going to get to God." Well, when we realize, understand, it's not our job to go to Him. He comes to us. He says, behold, I stand at the door knocking. If any man will open up, I'll come in. So while we're so busy trying to go after him, he comes to us. So before you can get into his presence, you have to realize that he's made the way for you to get into his presence by getting into your space. So it's not that deep. It's about accepting why he came. He says, I love the world so much that I gave my only begotten son, that whosoever believed in him. What a God that would send his son to the world in totality, but to me individually. Mm. I mean, it's a simple thing that and I equated to my father picked about four of us up before, but it was my father, but everybody got a ride. But even though it was it was my father individually, everybody was able to ride. Another thing my wife did, she separates clothes when she wants to wash them. Got the whites, the light darks, the darks. Mm-hmm. And she has to use three different machines because you can't put bleach in this one the whole nine yards. But one day God gave me a revelation. He said, when the world was dirty, he said, I put it all in one place.
Wow.
To clean it.
Just
one cleaner,
That's
the
good.
Blood, you know. And so us trying to get to him is really so simple. Mm. It's about opening the door. And he says, if you open up the door, he said, I'll sup with you. He said, I'm such a gentleman. I'm not going to bust the door down. But he said, getting to me is not deep. He said, as a matter of fact, the Bible says when we praise God, we enter into his presence. How do you get into his presence? By praising. So it's not about a journey to get there. It's about action. So that's where we have to be with him. We have to have the understanding that God wants us to be in his presence. He wants us. He wants us. Jesus says when we start to pray, we enter into his presence. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. We have to go to heaven. He said it's going to be here. He's bringing it to us. So I get excited, you know,
yes.
Because the way I teach people is if you really want to be in the presence of God, it's a state of mind, not a state of being. It's a state of mind.
Okay.
He that worship me, the woman at the well says, our fathers worshiped at this well. But Jesus said the time has come and now is that we must worship him in spirit and in truth. Not in a place, but in spirit. So it has to be with our minds. But then we talked about church. You know, people, this generation now don't like to go to church. We find any reason not to go to church. Well, you know, the preacher is crooked. The deacon, the choir members are crooked. Well, you know, we don't say that when it comes to Walmart, everybody go to Walmart's crooked. You know, we say, I don't go to church because all the preacher wants is my money. Well, that's all Walmart wants, but mm-hmm. you still go.
Right.
You know, I know crooked doctors, but when I get sick, I'm going to still call a doctor.
Right.
I know crooked attorneys. So we have to take away everything that's going to separate us from having that personal relationship, because a relationship with God, even though we come to church as a unit, the relationship is personal.
Yes.
I don't go to church for nobody else. I don't serve God for nobody else. So I'm not going to look at the downfall of somebody else and determine what my relationship with God ought to be.
You know?
So we have to be, it has to be personal. It's a personal relationship. And until you have that personal encounter with God, you will never understand how wonderful it is to be in his presence.
Yeah, yes, that is so true. And once you have that personal relationship with him, you want to spend time with him.
Sure.
In the word.
Sure.
Praying, meditating, all of those things.
Yeah.
And I don't know, I can tell the difference in my day. Mm-hmm. If I begin the day with the Lord, in the Word, praying, and if I don't, it seems like everything just goes every which way but the right way. But that helps me. But you are so right. I was just contacted this morning. Someone was talking about, well, this man of God isn't right because he's doing this, or they're taking money for this, and any excuse to fall away from the church or from God. It's not really even about falling away from the church. It's falling away from that relationship with God. And not everyone has that relationship.
Well, Lady Jackson, people don't want responsibility. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's really amazing to me that in this generation now, they don't want responsibility. It's like anything to get away from having to be accountable.
Right.
But the truth is that in every walk of life, there's crooked. In every walk of life, there are people that's wrong. You work with people that you know are trying to do you in, but you go back to work the very next day. Mm-hmm. You know, but it's only at church that we want to make an excuse why we shouldn't go and tell God and use people as an excuse on why we don't serve God. But I believe this. When you understand why he came, there's nothing that can deter you mm-hmm. from getting to where he is. I don't have to go to church to serve God. Well, we can go around about that. I got some scriptures for you. We can go around about that. But the Bible does tell us to forsake not to assemble ourselves together. And it lets us know that faith comes by hearing, hearing by the word of God. How can they hear without a preacher? How can they preach except to be sent? Every preacher is not crooked.
Right.
Every evangelist is not crooked. So you can't take one and then lump them all in the same category.
Correct.
But at the same time, again, relationship with God is personal. And until you're ready to make that personal commitment, when my faith is strong, there's nothing nobody can say to me that can turn me off from God. Mm-hmm. I've been doing this too long. I've been walking with God too long to know that there's nothing that anybody can say or do that'll turn me off from God. Nothing.
That's all right. That's good.
Nothing.
That's good. So, what could I say to that individual that is constantly putting that negative out there? What I really want to say is, why aren't you looking at what God has done rather than looking at all of this negative? There are some positives in the world as well.
2 Corinthians chapter 4 says this. For the God of this world hath blinded the minds of them which that believe not. He had blinded the minds. How can your mind be blind? Your mind is blind through unbelief. Mm. I know how to blind your eyes, but how do you blind your mind? You see, when I believe God, there's nothing that anybody can say or do to me to make me think that God is not coming. One of the more crucial things about life today is that people, if you're looking for an excuse, you'll find one. Mm-hmm. The only thing we do is to keep encouraging. But the Bible tells us in these days, in last days, it's going to be a great falling away. And so the Bible is steadily fulfilling itself. But there's a remnant of people that's going to believe God in spite of. We can go down the list of sins, lifestyles, and this. And I mean, you can go all the way down the list. But when it's all said and done, there's going to be some people that says, I still believe in holiness. I still believe what God said.
Yes.
I still believe we ought to live right. And it doesn't mean that we're going to be perfect. God, I wish I was perfect. You know, yes, I think my perfect state is when I'm sleeping. But don't let me have a dream too crazy. You know, but I think we you know, the church is only in a perfect state when the building is empty. Mm. But as soon as we walk in, the church becomes incomplete.
Yes.
But all of us, you know, I hear people saying this all the time. And I hope I'm not driven too far, but I hear people say this, that the church is the spiritual hospital, right? But the church today, the people today want to go to church to be accepted and not be helped. Mm-hmm. I'm going to say it one more time.
Yes.
They want to be accepted, but you can't go to Grandview. You can't go to Miami Valley. You can't go to no hospital and let them diagnose you. And then you say, oh, no, I'm not here to be healed or helped. I just want y'all to accept the way I am.
Mm-hmm. Like a social club.
Yeah. I mean, so you don't go there to just with a self-diagnosis.
Right.
You go there because whatever's wrong with me, I need you all to help me get well because I want to live. Well, it's the same thing at the church. When you walk in, there's a book that they diagnose your problem with and say, this is your issue, and this is the solution to your issue. You know, and you go in with the idea of, I can be helped here. If you walk in the hospital and say, I don't want to be helped, they say, well, why are you here? And then they make you sign a piece of paper. They say, if you leave here, AMA, against medical advice, if you go out and die, it's not our responsibility. I think the church ought to make people sign the same paper. You know, if you leave here against spiritual advice,
right,
and you go out and die, you can't blame the preacher. You can't blame the church because you died. Right. We tried to give you the best advice, but you called it bashing. You called it talking about me. But you're supposed to accept me to where I am. Come as you are. I take that. I get that. But you don't stay the way you are.
Amen.
Because we come to Christ to be helped.
Amen.
He sent not his son. People read gospel of the word, gave his only begotten son. We love John 3:16. But what about 3:17? For God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved.
Amen.
And we've got to, again, we can't understand how to go to him until we understand why he came to us.
Praise God. That's what a mighty word. Thank you. That is awesome. Now, not only is Pastor Washington a minister of the word, he is also a gifted and anointed singer. And we are going to be blessed at this time with a selection.
I was trying to get out of that.
Not today. From Pastor Kendall Washington.
How can I say thanks for the things you've done for me? Things so undeserved, yet you gave your life to prove your love for me. The voices of a million angels could not express my gratitude. All that I am and ever hope to be, I owe it all to thee. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. To God be the glory for the things he has done. With his blood he hath saved me. With his power he has raised me. To God be the glory for the things he has done. Just let me live my life, thank you, Lord, and let it be pleasing, Lord, to thee. And if I gain any praise, let it go to Calvary. Oh, with his blood he has saved me. With his power he has raised me. Oh, to God be the glory for the things, for the Dad! Jesus.
I'd like to thank all of my guests today, Pastor Kendall Washington, Carla Clay Alexander, and Cornita Castle. Thank you so much for being here. And until next time, remain in the presence of the Almighty God. Happy holidays to everyone.
In one place, in one time.